scientists are people. We are subject to all the frailties and all of the weaknesses, but also all of the strengths that everyone else is. That's one thing I would desperately hope that people will understand about scientists.
I'm a basic science researcher, so I'm an evolutionary biologist, and the particular system I work in is the evolution of spider silk. Most of what I spend my time doing is really, you know, trying to understand how spiders and how their silks came to be and how spider silk genetics might lead to a new generation of materials.
Almost everyone that does science wants to see their discoveries get applied to issues in the world that matter.
That is exhilarating. But it goes back towards our origins, understanding the way the world works and how that ties to who we are and how we interact with the world and how we interact with each other.
And so it's not as though scientists are some weirdo, something that's squirreled away in a closet. We are, and all scientists are very human, complete with all the pros and cons of the human activity. And it's something that is shared amongst every human activity, whether you're an artist, a chef, an engineer, it's really a shared activity.
There's some real realities to being a scientist that are hard. There's always this sense of uncertainty in the back of your mind that you don't quite understand what it is you're doing.
One has to make peace with pain is something I have been heard to say many times.
The act of discovery involves the act of being wrong a lot. Like 99% of the time you're wrong.
That you have to be at peace with being in a state of emotional distress at not getting what you want.
As scientists, we're human beings. Being human is incredibly messy. And that's not a bad thing.
So what sustains me during those periods when you're just sort of really trudging through doing the labor of science, it's just this belief that the discovery is just around the corner.
So much that we don't yet know. And so questions drive science, but scientists are humans. They come from a culture, they come from a background, they have individual experiences. So they're bringing to the table all those things.
Questions that we ask are always filtered through our worldview, of our way of understanding the world. And the way you understand the world doesn't happen on your own. You're socialized in a particular environment. And all of those factors will filter down into your science.
Study after study after study shows that diversity and inclusivity, different perspectives, different viewpoints, collaborating as a team makes for a better process of science.
So changing the demography of science also changes the enterprise of science, because people are going to have quite different ideas about what are the most important science problems and what are the most important applications.
Science is at its best when many voices are heard, when many experiences inform it, and when many people are curious.